Hello, good morning, dear brothers and sisters. Welcome to your Asian channel. Today, I have the joy of bringing you, for your information, a wonderful topic for which I have been preparing for years in order to be of help to the Lord. I am not worthy to serve her, nor does she need me in any way, but I feel very happy and very honored to bring you this information regarding the mission of her present life here as Aida Romero, the beings of light, and make me a summary list so that you can understand the magnitude and scope of the mission of the life of this lady called Aida Romero. So without further delay, brothers and sisters, I am going to start reading you this list, which I hope you will find easy to understand. I have put a lot of interest, and the beings of light have been magnificent with me with a lot of patience because I am slow to understand them. But here we go, brothers and sisters, so that a faithful testimony of the lady may be given, I am going to instruct you in the most essential and in what you need to be prepared to say clearly and understandably what her mission is and the previous announcement of her advent by Nostradamus 500 years before. First of all, it is the respect with which the lady must be treated, as warned by the spirits assigned to her court and custody, which are numerous and very powerful, neutralizing any anomaly or damage that the ignorance of some mortals tried to harm her. I was instructed, with the utmost care and deep respect with which I should treat her, with the title of Lady prefixed to her name. I was also instructed about the mission of the lady, which covers immense fields or spheres of action, of which I will not be able to give a list of all of them, but I can provide an understandable summary or synthesis. First, to help the transition from these final times to the terrestrial evolutions, dedicating all your physical and spiritual forces. Second, to attract to the light that it brings from God all those who are predisposed to receive it. Third, receive the change to a golden dawn. Fourth, to help the nations of the whole world with the decrees that God seals in the spiritual world, once she seals them with her word, mind, and mudra of her arms. Fifth, to masterfully change the global economic system by divine design, so that they don't grind the face of the poor anymore, and to remove humanity as a whole from the system of pseudo-slavery in which it finds itself due to the unfair distribution of wealth. Sixth, her spiritual body is of heavenly glory, which is the highest among beings of light. This means that her spirit is glorified. This is shown through her eyes and her gaze. Seventh, power to command the elements, whose attribution can only be carried out by beings of light with the aforementioned celestial glory. 8. The power of the multiplication of her form, allowing her to be in countless places at once as needed. This power is analogous to the call of a saint who can grant graces to many people. 9. The wisdom that comes out of her mouth continuously enlightens those who walk erratically. 10. Her love towards the animal kingdom and all divine creation. 11. The power to work miracles with the mercy of God and to heal the brokenhearted by unifying them physically and spiritually. I humbly ask the nations to listen to her so that her time on earth is as fruitful as possible. To all the people who love her, I beg in union of prayers for the mission of the lady. Thank you, dear brothers and sisters. May any ignorant person who belittles or harms her in any way not to be held innocent in the eyes of God, be excluded from the Church of the Firstborn. Thank you very much.